Let's get lit.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Before I start to tell you what I want to tell in this video, let me introduce myself. My name is Anggraini. My student ID number is 19102062. The study program is Government Science Employee Class. Okay, now in this video, I want to tell you a little about Development Theory of Deconstructions or Reconstructions, second edition by Jan Niederman-Peters. And I've divided my talk into a few sections. The first is the developments in questions. The second is the status of development theory. The third is the meanings of developments over time. The fourth is development in struggle. And the last is development in field. Okay, let me describe one by one of them. Trends in development theory. For the first is development in question. From its 19th century beginnings, development thinking was a reaction to its previous progress, such as social dislocation caused by industrialization. The second is the status of development theory. Theory is a distillation of reflections on practice in conceptual language, so as to connect with past knowledge. Theories are contextual, while theories react to the other theories and often emphasize differences rather than complementarities. The complexities encountered in reality are such that we usually need several analytics in combination. The strength and the weakness of the development thinking is its policy-oriented character. This is the part of the vitality and the inventiveness.
The current development thinking represents that from the post-war era of modern development thinking.
In modern development thinking and economics, the core meanings of the developments was economic growth, as in growth theory and big push theory. The fourth is development is struggle. Each perspective unfolds in a several particular historical settings, understanding development theory in context that means understanding it as a response to a problem and arguments at time. Another dimension is explanations or assumptions about causal relationship. In addition, it involves methodology or indicators and research methods. Development thinking also performs a role of representations of articulating and privileging particular political and class interests and cultural preferences. And the fifth is the development in field. Development thinking and policy then is the terrain of the hegemony and counter-hegemony. In these contestations of interest, there are many stakeholders and multiple centers of power and influence. To the surface structures of these percenters of the influence, you can add the infrastructures of force behind the scenes. That is, those on whom your percenters of influence depend. Thus, what matters are not simply that the World Bank or IMF, but their birth of trustees and other force that shapes policy parameters. And for the last, I want to tell you a little about the trends of development theory. If it is true that the development is a mirror of the time, then the development trends report is to look in the collective mirror, and there are many angles to take and arguments to fit the occasion. And the trends of the development theory have any structure. The first is interdisciplinarity. The second is discourse analysis. The third is the culture and development. And the last is intersectoral cooperation. A Okay, there are the little descriptions about the development theory of deconstructions or reconstructions, second editions by Jan Nederven Peters. Thank you for watching my video, and Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.